In this video, I'd like to show you how to use the study mode, especially when you're using note decks as flashcards. If we go into our flashcard deck, the study mode is found in the drop-down menu at the top, and this is the icon for study mode. When you click on study mode, you get a series of options. You can shuffle the cards, you can choose to show the back of the card first, and you can also choose which cards to show. There's quite a few options here, so let me explain. When you are working in study mode, you will be able to flag the answer as right, wrong, or not sure. This is using the Leitner model space repetition method. So as you work through your study decks, you may find over time that you've got some that are right, some that are wrong, and you can select the ones that you want to see. You can also just study certain cards in certain groups or ones that you've tagged in a certain label. And finally, you can also just show and study the cards that you've made as a favorite. At this point, we haven't done any of that, and we have 5 cards in the stack. So I'm going to click Start. Now we see the study mode, and as I mentioned, we can now give it an answer based on how well we understood and learned this slash card. So once I've decided if I think I know the answer or not, I can choose to flip to the back and check my answer. And just for the sake of convenience and speed, I'll just sort of click through these cards in a random way, giving answers so that we can see how the study mode works. And as you can see here, we finished the study deck and it said I got 2 out of 5 right. I got 1 wrong, 2 flagged as not sure, 2 as right. At this point, we can choose to study again or close. If I click study again, you'll see now that we've got numbers next to wrong, not sure, and right, and that tells you how many are in those buckets. And I could choose to just study my not sure or the wrong cards. So let's say in this case, I just want to study the wrong and the not sure. Now we see the study mode again, and let's say you got this right, got this one right, and this one right. You'll also notice at the top of the card, when you exit the study mode, the cards have a little study symbol, and this shows you the status of your study. So if I go back to the view, we see that we marked all of the cards as correct. Let's do another study mode again, and this time I'm going to reset the data. When I do that, if I click close, you'll see that we now no longer have green icons on the cards, and we're ready to study again. And this time, if I do a very quick study, this time just to show the different icons, you'll see now that the cards have the color of the status of our study. So this is great to get a quick visual overview of how far you've come in studying for your stack. You'll also notice at the top of the screen, we have an icon which we can use to filter, and I can just filter on the cards that have got right or wrong. Once again, if I go back into study mode, if I want to reset the data, I can click reset study data and everything is back to square one. So that's how the study mode works in note decks. Please let us know how we can improve the study mode, and we hope you are successful in your studies. Thank you.